Karibu sana Mheshimiwa Rais, utuongoze kwa sherehe hizi muhimu sana za kufuzu. Utuongoze rasmi katika sherehe hizi. Thank you.
nitakuwa mwaminifu na mtiifu kwa rais, amiri jeshi mkuu na jamhuri ya Kenya.
The best recruit all round, number 157704, recruit Gabriel Kipanga, Kenya Army.
We are charging you with the duty of protecting this nation from assailants and intruders, and it is important for you to appreciate that we still need to invest more effort to downgrade and degrade the Al-Shabaab terrorists so as to not only safeguard our sovereignty and territorial integrity, but also help stabilize the entire Eastern African region. The training you have undergone is to empower you with the skills necessary to solve this problem. You are in the service of justice, and you are the agents and protectors of this nation. This is your ultimate contribution to the people of Kenya, who by accepting to pay tax have sacrificed to ensure you successfully discharge your duties, and I urge you to apply yourselves in the most patriotic and professional manner at all times. Let me reiterate what I said to the graduates as new recruits to the service and as young makers of this country. Our success on national development goals that we have set for ourselves as a people depends on you, our young people. However, you must be purpose-driven. If you become a community of solution givers and problem solvers, success will inevitably follow you. This is how our international development goals, as well as our national development goals, will be realized. So therefore, ladies and gentlemen, with these remarks, let me once again take this opportunity to wish each and every one of these new soldiers success in their future careers. I thank you. God bless you all. God protect you as you go about your service. And indeed, may God continue blessing this great nation of Kenya. We all know what damage coronavirus disease has done to us and indeed to the world. And this pandemic has compelled institutions the world over to change their traditions and ways of doing things by adopting a new normal. So I'm therefore delighted to learn that this institution has observed a total lockdown since the first case was reported in the country. And as a result, you have managed to avoid contracting this disease despite the large number of recruits and trainers involved. This is a clear evidence that we can contain and eliminate the spread of the virus, and which underscores that discipline is fundamental in all spheres of life. Ladies and gentlemen, at this point, I would like to register my appreciation and indeed the appreciation of the people of Kenya, of the fact that the Kenya Defense Forces has continued to be a symbol of our nationhood. Its organization and the symbolic relationship between its members, drawn from different communities in Kenya, living and working together as one team, is indeed inspiring and demonstrates that we are indeed one people and one nation. We also recognize the contribution that our defense forces continue to make to our country as a whole, especially in utilizing your skills and assets to spearhead selected strategic development projects. The rehabilitation works, for example, on the Nairobi-Nanyuki meter gauge railway, the work done by Navy engineers in rehabilitating the Kisumu port, and the ongoing Nakuru-Kisumu line, the work that is ongoing there, are a few of such projects that the Defense Forces has executed with excellence. And for this reason, we are indeed proud of your contribution to the realization of the Vision 2030 journey. I urge all Kenyans today, and indeed all government agencies, to emulate this commitment of excellence from our Kenya Defense Forces. Further, I wish to commend all the Kenya Defense Forces for their professional conduct during operations and support to civil authority. As Commander-in-Chief of the Security Forces, I am proud of the high standards of the parade you recruits have displayed here today. And I, however, once again, urge each and every one of you to emulate your superiors and to continue to strive to acquire further knowledge and skills so that you can effectively meet the challenges that lie ahead. Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, part of my solemn duty as your Commander-in-Chief is the protection of Kenyans, their property, and the preservation of our sovereignty and territorial integrity. And it is for this reason that I laud the efforts of the Kenya Defense Forces in the fight against terrorism, as well as that of all other security agents. Our engagement in various initiatives like AMISOM, aimed at defeating terrorism, have yielded significant successes. My direct instruction to you all, therefore, is to embrace impartiality over prejudice, restore goodness and humanity, as well as let us together build this nation. You have voluntarily joined this honorable profession, and for that reason, I am confident that you will discharge your duty as is expected of you. Indeed, today, I note with appreciation that several female recruits have completed the course with their male counterparts, and this is yet another manifestation of my administration's commitment to ensure equal opportunities to all, and indeed, to empower our women folk. Ladies and gentlemen, it is important for these young women working alongside men to find meaning and purpose in their work. When these young men and women joined the Kenya Defense Forces from all parts of this great nation, they became one cohesive family. And together, your mission is clear: to protect our country's sovereignty and territorial integrity, defend our people, and undertake any other tasks assigned to you from time to time. In the defense of our motherland and fulfilling our international obligations to pursue peace and security, it is important to note that we have lost some of our gallant soldiers. These losses are not in vain. Their sacrifices for freedom and our motherland strengthens our resolve. And to that end, I would like to ask you all to be upstanding for 1 minute of silence in remembrance of all those gallant officers and servicemen and women. Graduates, the dynamic security environment you will be operating in demands that you continue to sharpen your skills. Moreover, you will need to enhance your knowledge on national, regional, and international security threats. This way, you will have a much better understanding of how to operate within and without our territorial boundaries. Let me at this point note with appreciation the role that the Kenya Defense Forces has also played and continues to play in regional security stabilization, specifically, as I stated earlier, in the war against terror. While we have made good progress, it is important to note that we still have security challenges that require our attention, and I do believe that you are the right people for that job. Ladies and gentlemen, our nation takes pride in the high standard that has been the hallmark of our defense forces. Our military personnel continue to play a major role in international assignments, such as the United Nations peace support operations, including the African Union and IGAD missions in various parts of the world. The continuous participation of our military in these missions reflects the confidence of the international community through the United Nations and the Security Council in particular, has in our nation's defense forces. This indeed is true testimony of the high standards of our military training as well as your professionalism.